Through the Flames, Part 1. Romy was mounting his bicycle when he saw smoke rising from behind the distant line of trees.
It looks like a fire. It's well to the east, nowhere near the road. There is a strong wind,
said Prem, looking at the dry leaves swirling across the road. It hadn't rained for several weeks. The brown grass and leaves of the trees were covered with dust. It was almost 6 o'clock in the evening and the boys were sweating.
It will be dark soon. The fire is spreading. Spend the night at my house. No, my father isn't keeping well. The doctor has given me some pills for him. The fire is far off. It will take me only 40 minutes to ride through the forest. Bye. See you tomorrow.
Romy pedaled off, scattering stray hens, stray dogs and stray villagers. His village, which lay on the other side of the forest, only had a primary school. So, Romy had to go to the high school in another village. His father, a fairly wealthy sugarcane farmer, had recently bought him a bicycle. Romy wanted to get the pills to his father as early as possible. He rode swiftly out of the village. The smoke rose from the burning forest and the sky glowed red. There was a slight climb and Romy had to push harder on the pedals to get over the rise. Once over the top, the road went winding down to the edge of the forest. Romy relaxed and stopped pedaling and allowed the bicycle to glide down the slope. When the road straightened out, Romy began pedaling again. The smoke was thicker and he could smell the burning of timber. But the road was clear, so he rode on. Tall trees grew on either side of the rough and dusty road, cutting off the last of the daylight. But the spreading glow of the fire on the right lit up the road and giant tree shadows danced on the bicycle. The usually deserted road was alive with wild creatures fleeing from the forest fire. Romy first saw a hare leaping across the road in front of him. It was followed by several more hares. Then a band of monkeys ran across, chattering excitedly.
They'll be safe on the other side. The fire won't cross the road.
But it was coming closer. Realizing this, Romy pedaled harder. In half an hour, he should be out of the forest. Suddenly, from the side of the road, several pheasants rose in the air and with a whoosh flew low across the path just in front of the oncoming bicycle. Taken by surprise, Romy fell off. When he picked himself up and brushed his clothes, he saw that his knee was bleeding. It wasn't a deep cut, but he allowed it to bleed a little, took out his handkerchief and bandaged his knee. He rode a bit slower now because birds and animals kept coming out of the bushes. Not only pheasants, but smaller birds too were streaming across the road. Parrots, jungle crows, owls, magpies, and the air was filled with their cries.
Everyone's on the move. It must be a really big fire.
He could see the flames now, reaching out from behind the trees on his right, and he could hear the crackling as the dry leaves caught fire. The air was hot on his face. Leaves still alight or turning to cinders floated past. A herd of deer crossed the road and Romy had to stop until they had passed. Then he mounted again and rode on, but now, for the first time, he was feeling afraid. From ahead came a faint clanging sound. It wasn't an animal sound. Romy was sure of that a fire engine. There were no fire engines within 50 miles. The clanging came nearer and Romy discovered that the noise came from a small boy who was running along the forest path. Two milk cans clattering at this side.
Teju, what are you doing here? Teju. Trying to get home, of course. Romy, jump on.
Teju was only 8 or 9, a couple of years younger than Romy. He had come to deliver milk to some road workers, but the workers had left at the first signs of the fire, and Teju was hurrying home with his cans still full of milk. He got up on the crossbar of the bicycle and Romy moved on again. He was quite used to carrying friends on the crossbar.
Romy, keep beating your milk cans. Like that, the animals will know we are coming.
My bell doesn't make enough noise.
I am going to get a horn for my bicycle. Teju, I didn't know there were so many animals in the jungle. I saw a python in the middle of the road. It stretched right across. Romy, what did you do? Teju, I just kept running and jumped right over it.
Teju continued to chatter, but Romy's thoughts were on the fire, which was much closer now. Flames shot up from the dry grass and ran up the trunks of the trees and along the branches. Smoke billowed out above the forest. Romy's eyes were smarting and his hair and eyebrows felt scorched. He was feeling tired, but he couldn't stop now. He had to get beyond the range of the fire. Another 10 or 15 minutes of steady riding would get them to the small wooden bridge that spanned the little river separating the forest from the sugarcane fields. Once across the river, they would be safe. The fire could not touch them on the other side because the forest ended at the river's edge. But could they get to the river in time?